Disclaimer: the topic Indian Railway Works Contract Management has been divided into multiple videos to bring in simplicity and to enable the audience to enjoy learning. The text and data that are being displayed here are for guidance only. For actual practice, references should be made to the original codes, manuals, circulars, and letters. The depiction made here are for introduction to the system and are subject to additions, alterations, modification to establish control of authority and protection of data access. Welcome to the video. This is the 9th video on IRWCMS. In this video, we are going to have an abstract view of on-account measurements in IRWCMS module. On-account measurements in IRWCMS, an abstract view. The aim of this video. The aim of this video is to familiarize the user to make on-account measurements in the IRWCMS module. As we have already seen, measurements in IRWCMS module. In IRWCMS, we have a measurements module. Once you click on measurements, it will have two menu. One is normal contract. The second one will be zonal contract. Now we are dealing with normal contract. So once we click on that, it will show inform contractor for measurement, enter basic measurement details, initiation of measurement, review by site engineer, forward to engineer's representative, action by engineer's representative, action by engineer, and then outbox. Now, since we have already made record measurements, now we have to inform contractor for measurement. We have already made the basic measurement details. We have already entered the basic measurement details. So we need not do that. We can directly go into initiation of measurement. In that, we have to select on account measurement. So let's see. And again, we have to keep the detailed measurements ready, and we have to keep the scanned copies of all the certificates which we are planning to upload in the CC. Recovery certification also. If you want to recover for water charges, if you want to recover for non-engagement of engineering graduate, if you want to make any other recoveries, you have to make all those details ready and keep it on hand. Okay, now click on measurements module, click on normal contract, inform contractor for measurement. Inform contractor for measurement will be same as previously we had done for the record measurements. You have to hit search, it will list the LOAs, select the LOA, details will be mentioned here. Now here, instead of record measurement, we have to click on account and propose a date, propose a time, click on send, it will be sent to the message will be sent to the contractor. Now we have already informed the contractor. Now we have to go to initiation of measurement. Click on initiation of measurement, and now this time we have to select on account measurement. Now we are going for on account measurement. Click on search, select the LOA, now it will be like this. See, measurement details, previously we have uploaded, all those details are listed here, we cannot edit these. Then uploaded documents, whatever documents we uploaded during recording stage will be listed here. See here, we have eligible record measurement details, MB number, so on. So this is the record measurement that we had already recorded. The recorded measurements signed by SSE, then signed by contractor, and finalized by ADN only will appear here. If they are not finalized, it will not be appearing here. Then now we have on account measurement entry CC number 1. This is our first contract certificate. First contract CC, that is contract certificate number 1. Measurement number is by default it is appearing. MB number by default it is appearing. Measurement date also. Once we scroll down, here we have this table. Already we had entered four items. This is item number 1, item 1, 2, 3, and 4. We had already recorded this much quantity, 44.39, 40.19, etc. Now again, there is a last column called actions column. In that we have green color tab and red color tab. Whenever we want to add a measurement, click on that green color and the item will open up. Also, before that, we have this eligible record measurement details, MB number, so on. So if we click on that, it will open up like this. Download signed MB. If you want to download the signed record measurements, you can click on here. These are the previously recorded measurements. See, all these things are recorded and we cannot edit these things. You can only view the details. Okay. Now I am planning to edit one of the items. That is, from here 1, 2, 3, 4 is listed here. I am going to click on the green color button for concrete. I have selected the 136 measurement, 136 concrete mix. It is measured in cubic meters. Eligible brought forward measurements. These are the eligible brought forward measurements. Already we had entered 40.19 cubic meters. Now whatever measurement we are going to enter, we can select it. We can add the particulars. We can enter the measurements. And then if there are more measurements, we can add rows. After that, click on save. Similarly, for all these items, we can add. Not only these items, if we want to add new items, that also can be done. We have this add new item button. We can add even new items, that is, apart from those which we had recorded earlier. We had already recorded 4 items. Say if we have another few new items, that is another 4 or 5 new items, we can add those new items. The measurements are to be fed like whatever we did in the record measurement, same way. After completing adding all those items, we have to add the measurements, save them, and we have to click on add certificate. So now we can add certificate. Whatever certificate applies to our railway, we can select, tick those boxes. After that, if we have any documents to upload, we can upload them, choose the file, upload it. Document description has to be typed here. Click on upload and remarks. Forward for acceptance. This has to be forwarded to the contractor for his acceptance. Here you have save as draft, confirm and generate PDF. If we click on this confirm and generate PDF, the measurements will be freezed. After this, we will not be able to make any changes to the measurements. Once we click there, the PDF is generated. Detailed measurements PDF is generated. If we look into it, here we have quantity brought forward from MB number. So and so, that is from the record measurements, we have taken it here, and the PDF will look like this. So everything has been saved successfully, PDF has been generated, it has been saved successfully. Now we have sign and forward to contractor. If we click on this, are you sure you want to sign and forward this measurement? Click OK. Mark measurement marked successfully. It has been measurement marked to contractor. This goes to the contractor. Now contractor has to go through his login page, go into his login page, accept the measurements, and he has to mark it again to the SSC. Now again it reaches the SSC. Whenever the documents are digitally signed, it will appear like this here. So we have sent it to the contractor. We assume that contractor also has accepted the measurement and he has marked it back to the SSC. Now SSC has to send it to ADN for technical check, test check, and for further processing, for further billing activities. So once again, go into measurements module, click on normal contract, come to forward to engineer's representative. Earlier what we had done was initiation of measurement. Then we clicked on account measurement. Now we have to click forward to engineer's representative, click on account measurement. Again, search is appearing. Click on search, select your LOA. This is how it will appear. And at the bottom, you will have forward measurement to engineer's representative. Click on this. Measurement marked successfully. Measurement marked to ADN1 MAS. So, finally, we have sent the measurements to ADN for test check. In the previous video, we have seen how to make record measurements. And in this video, we have seen how to add those record measurements and to add any new measurements, if any, and prepare on-account measurements. Once on-account measurements are made ready, it has to be sent to the contractor. Say by sequence, when we come back, we have to inform contractor for on-account measurement. Then we have to initiate measurements, initiation of measurement. In initiation of measurement, we have to click on account measurement. Click on that, feed the details, provide the measurement details. After doing all those things, generate the work order, send it to contractor. Contractor has to accept it and he has to send it back to the SSC. SSC now sends it to ADN for test check. So inform contractor for measurement, enter basic measurement details, initiation of measurement. This entering of basic measurement details will happen only once, not required frequently. So we are ready to make on-account measurements in the IRWCMS module, that is EMBOK. Save water, every drop counts. Suggestions are always welcome. Suggestions can be sent to a.s.ramchennai@gmail.com. Thank you.